Mother. What big dust balls you have.
Ooh! This sweet but sloppy grandma is trapped in a filthy fairy tale.
Grandmother, what big piles of disgusting dishes you have.
Can I keep this?
No!
How about this?
No!
Can Kim and Aggie help Grandma live hygienically ever after?
Mirror, mirror, on the wall, who is the cleanest of them all?
Britain's princesses of purification, Kim Woodburn and Aggie McKenzie, have sailed the seas to sanitize the states. This week, they're in La Fuente, California.
We're going to see a woman called Charlotte, who's in her early 50s.
She's a grandma, isn't she?
She is.
Grandma Charlotte works in an art supply store, and her house has become so crowded with her craft projects and clothes and crud, she's got no room for her relatives.
Because of the house being so messy, we don't allow the grandkids to come over. We'll go somewhere else. They love the park. And I even get on the slides and the swings with them.
All right!
I don't remember the last time I've been to my grandma's house.
We've never come across that before. It's ridiculous, isn't it? Imagine not being able to invite your grandchildren.
Oh, hi. My mom's very outgoing, very social, very friendly, and I think she limits her ability to socialize and invite family and friends over to her house because of the way it looks.
It'd be fun to hang out at Grandma's house.
Over the river and through the woods to Grandma's house we don't go.
It's not much of a fairy tale,
no,
is it, Kim?
It's a flipping nightmare, isn't it?
What antiseptic adventures await as Kim and Aggie approach Grandmother's chaotic cottage?
Kim?
It's the House of Horrors.
That is disgusting. Oh, God, isn't that awful? Caked in dust. Oh, don't do that. Oh!
I've lived in my house since 1975, and it's gotten a lot of clutter around it. Too much stuff. I'm a pack rat.
Crafts. Craft stuff. Everything's in boxes.
Oh, there's more furniture underneath here. It's a table.
It's all brand new.
Why?
Do you know, it's like a warehouse. A bomb's gone off in.
Oh! God help me.
You're all right there, Kim. You're managing.
Oh, I'm having a ball. What are you doing?
I'm having a good laugh over here.
Look, Axe. This is the top of a little table.
Mm. Oh, my goodness!
Now gather round and hear the story of Grandma's slimy lavatory.
Oh, Kim.
Oh, no.
Kim.
Oh, no.
Oh,
no.
Oh, I think I'm going to be sick now.
Kim is baby cockroaches!
The living.
Oh my God, she's bathing with cockroaches. How foul is that?
The next chapter in this scary tale takes place in the slovenly spare room.
The name of all that's holy.
What is going on in this woman's head?
Sometimes I try to get organized and I'll go ahead and take everything out of one room and start to clean it up, but then I'll throw something back in that room and starts getting cluttered all over again.
When do you think she last went into that corner?
And when was the last time anyone dared to enter this monstrous mess hall?
Oh my God, have you seen the kitchen? She needs rescuing. This is awful.
I need rescuing. This has just got to stop. Get in.
My mom's sink broke a couple years ago, so she decided that she couldn't do dishes anymore, and they've been there since.
Oh!
This fearsome fable is about to take a chilling turn.
Oh my God, ants in the freezer!
Oh, I've never seen ants in a freezer before.
Well, I've had ants in your pants, too, never in a freezer.
Not in a freezer.
Legend has it there's a giant lurking in Grandma's bedroom. A giant pile of clothes.
There can't be a bed in there,
Abby. Look, behind
where?
The heap, behind the mountain.
Oh, I can't believe. She doesn't sleep. No, she doesn't. Oh, it's not natural.
I mean, how deep is this pile? It's just... It's a mountain, isn't it? It's a mountain range, in fact.
Love it.
Oh, Aggie, hang on. I'm shoving this dust along. Pick it up at your end.
I've got it.
Pick it up at your end.
Got it here. Meeting in the middle.
How solid is this heap of clothes? I'm jumping up and down here. I'm not making any impression on this mountain.
Do you know,
here.
Aggie, I can honestly say this to you. I haven't had a good jump in years, Dad.
Oh, Kim. Kim, look at this on the curtain.
Oh, my goodness. That's one big granddaddy cockroach.
Well, don't wave it over me, dear. I don't like them.
I'm so glad you're dead.
Go on, Kim. Get out, you dirty thing.
And so the cleaning queens completed their investigation and confronted the grimy grandma.
Oh, hello, you Charlotte?
Yes, I am.
We can't get over the state of your place.
Oh, I know, it's a little cluttery.
No, it's not a little cluttery, it's unbelievably bad.
Yes, it is very bad.
Oh, you admit that?
Yes, I do.
Isn't she sassy? Tell me something, you wouldn't be a shopaholic, would you?
Well, some people think I am, but I don't think so.
You are?
No.
You are?
Okay, I'm a shopaholic.
You come with us, because we've got a story to tell you.
And now it's time for Kim and Aggie's Filthy Fairy Tales.
Once upon a time, there was a dear, sweet, loving grandmother who lived in a very filthy, grimy house.
Her devoted daughter couldn't bring the grandchildren to stay for fear that they might say,
Grandmother, what big dust balls you have. Grandmother, what big piles of dirty, disgusting dishes you have. Any of this ring true?
It's beginning to sound a little familiar.
Yes. Finally, along came two fairy godmothers.
And they helped Grandmother make the dirt disappear.
And she and her family lived happily ever after.
Does this sound good to you?
Yes, it sounds great.
Right then, let's get going. Now, first, we need to get decluttering in here, OK?
OK.
But we've got a very special person who's come to help.
Okay? Yes, we have.
Mm-hmm. OK.
And with a wave of their wands, Grandmother's daughter appeared.
So we got a lot of cleaning to do.
Yes, a lot.
Good, we'll do it together.
OK.
And so they did. Melissa helped Charlotte eradicate the evil clutter so the tidy godmothers could get cleaning.
No! How about this?
No!
How about these books?
No!
While Grandmother wanders through the wilderness of waste, little Aggie Riding Hood has to skip into her scrubbing suit. But beware of the British Big Bad Wolf.
Help!
Now it's out of the woods and into Grandma's grimy grotto. Spending hours scouring floors may be all right for Cinderella, but Kim knows how to make a chore much more charming.
These are ceramic tiles.
Yes, they're ceramic tiles, and you have to get on your hands and knees to clean them, and I got bad knees, so I can't.
Well, you see, I'm going to solve that right now for you, because a Swiffer wet jet, you don't have to, darling. There's no buckets, which, I mean, are awful. Put it on the floor, okay? I've got the button here.
Oh, look at that.
Off we jolly well go. Right, now, I'm going to whip it over. Oh, yes.
Great job. Look at that.
I've done these three. Will you do these three alongside, my love? Now, come on. You don't need to strain yourself.
It's really simple.
No, I've done those three. Get off my half. Look at this section and that section. There is a massive difference.
Definitely.
But you know what proves it?
Next, Aggie concocts a wondrous brew to make Grandma's furniture look new.
The dust in here, it's incredible. There's layers and layers and layers of it.
Yeah.
So we're going to have to cut through that, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
Into a mixture of fragrant lemon oil and warm water go two lint-free cloths for perfect polishing.
These cloths will trap the dust the lemon oil feeds the wood. You leave the cloth to dry and then put them in a jar like this and put the lid back on. Now here's some I made earlier. Okay, so I'll take the lid off. Now, can you smell the lemon oil in there? Mm-hmm. You take that one, Charlotte. Melissa? What a shame, there's only two.
Oh, I'll share.
No, it's quite all right. I'll just have to stand by and watch. Look at all that dust.
Oh my God, that's gross.
I just can't resist.
Are you ready?
I am ready.
Let it go. Woo! Ew. Mom, look at this. Years of dust gone in less than a minute. Okay? So don't get in that state again. You and Michelle.
I hear you.
One of the rooms in Grandmother's house is a breeding ground for evil intruders. Which one could it be? And do Kim and Aggie possess secret supernatural cleaning powers? There once lived a sweet grandma named Charlotte, whose house was so full of filth her family couldn't fit inside. But with the help of her two tidy godmothers and her daughter Melissa, Charlotte was soon mopping and dusting her way to a healthy home. In Grandma's craft-filled cottage, flowers can bloom forever and get covered with crud. So Kim has a sudsy solution.
Woo! We can't mess around all day. Just put that down. I'm going to wash the silk flowers. It's as simple as that. All I'm going to put in this bowl of water is bubble bath.
Just a capful?
Yes. Next door to it, we've got rinsing water. You're going to take some fabric softener. Now, give it a stir, my love, because I'm going to rinse them in that. How long have you had these silk flowers, by the way?
Have they ever been washed? No, they haven't.
Well, that's very true, Flover, isn't it? Now, I'm going to immerse the leaves, and I'm going to whip it up as quickly as I can. So I hand it to you, in, out, as quick as a whistle. Now, get together, girls. We are now on a conveyor belt. Washer, rinser, dryer. I get two jobs because I'm brainy.
Oh.
And I'm also... I'm not saying much for you two, but still. But honestly, this is how simple it is. Woo! These are now lovely. There's my display. Look at the water, and look at so far. Now, Mother, I'm going to present those to you, and I think they're very, very beautiful. And I'll tell you something. Do they fiff and well smell good?
Now, to help make Grandmother's house the purest in all of the land, our kindly cleaning queens have sent out a call for some sanitary assistance.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
The workers whistle while they wash and wipe. They clean every corner to keep those creepy critters from crawling back. Next, Aggie shows Charlotte how to avoid huffing and puffing and sneezing her house down.
Now, Charlotte, you suffer from allergies, don't you?
Yes, I have bad allergies, really bad.
So it can't help trying to sleep in a dusty room, can it?
No, not at all.
Okay, here I've got Febreze with allergen reducer in it. It can cut down up to 75% of the allergy particles in the air. As the mist falls to the mattress, it traps the allergenic particles. And what you do then is get a little baby vacuum cleaner and start sweeping up, okay? And if you're not vacuuming them, then you'll have millions and millions of dust mites on here. And the feces from the dust mites will give you allergic reactions as well, okay? Come on, let's breathe. Ooh. Is that better?
Yes.
You can have the lead part in Sleeping Beauty every night now.
Okay, sounds terrific.
Marvelous.
Grandma's dirt-laden lamp may not have a genie inside, but her daughter's made a wish to restore its soiled shade.
I'm going to immerse this toothbrush in water, okay? But I'm going to partially dry it off, then I'm going to immerse it in the baking soda. It helps the baking soda cling more. And I'm simply going to do that. Bring it down in that. Ooh, the filth's coming off this, isn't it? When that dries, it'll be about three shades lighter than that. Look how lovely and clean they are.
Wow, it looks so much lighter.
It does. Beautiful. So flick off what you've done so far. You'll see baking soda falling down.
Does the Mad Hatter spring to mind?
Yes, lovely.
Oh, come on.
And while the cleaners cast their spell on the sludge, Kim goes after that grubby looking glass.
A streak-free shine, Charlotte. Ooh, very nice.
Beautiful.
Mirror, mirror, on the wall, who is the cleanest of them all?
You are, my queen.
Thank you. Mirror, mirror, on the wall, who's the most beautiful of them all?
You are, of course.
Thank you.
Oh, now I'm all smudged again. For this tale to have a happy ending, the gang gets into high gear, and Grandma's got to get going.
We're going to finish off in there now, so you two Cinderellas can run off to the ball. Oh, I mean mall.
The eager elves make the muck disappear, and Kim and Aggie work their own special magic.
I hope Charlotte appreciates all this hard work.
Oh, I think she will.
Will an unexpected visitor help grandmother's dreams finally come true? Grandma Charlotte's house was out of a fairy tale. Grim, that is. She couldn't even invite her daughter and grandson inside. Then two sanitary sorceresses appeared to try and turn her cluttered cottage into a pristine palace. At last, Charlotte and her dear daughter returned to see if Kim and Aggie have lifted the dirty curse.
Now, ladies, the house is clean. We're ready to go in.
But we just got one more surprise.
Grandma!
Let's
all go in now.
Okay. See? More surprises. Come on, lad. Come on.
Grandma's living room was a forest of unopened packages, unnecessary purchases, and unfathomable filth. Now it's a flawless fantasy.
Whoa! What? Oh, look how pretty! Oh, look!
It looks beautiful.
So can you imagine entertaining your grandchildren and your friends in here?
I can invite them in, open the door, and say, come in!
So what's going to stop you from ordering some more goods off the TV and crashing the place up again? No, what's going to stop you from doing that?
I'm not going to, because I want it to stay exactly the way it is.
This bedroom was the land of massive clothing mountains and dreadful dust bunnies. Now the chaos has been conquered, and Grandma can slumber in serenity.
Oh my God! Look at that!
Now she could finally stretch her legs out.
Sweet Charlotte was besieged by bugs in her tub and scum on her surfaces. Now her restroom's been rescued from a filthy fate.
Oh, wow!
Look at that! Would you take a bath in there? That's what I want to know.
Yeah.
Grandma wanted a workshop in her spare room, but there wasn't a spot to spare. Now it's a spacious and well-kept work of art.
Oh my God!
Look at that! That is absolutely great!
Look!
You can be totally organized now.
Oh, yes.
And really, really enjoy it.
Between the ice-cold insects and the crud-coated cooktop, this was one wicked witch of a kitchen. Till Kim and Aggie made it safe for a sanitary supper.
Oh, my God. Oh, look.
Oh, honey. Truthfully now, when was the last time you saw this house or kitchen this clean?
Oh, my gosh. Ages. Years.
Years.
If you look up above you, we've left behind a range of products to help you on your way.
Their antiseptic efforts at an end, the tidy godmothers bid farewell to the grateful grandma and her happy family.
Very nice to meet you. Another little chat.
Bye, everyone.
Bye. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
2 weeks have passed. Has Charlotte kept the webs away? Good going, Grandma. The living room still looks lovely and virtually litter-free.
Okay, the impact has been really great since Kim and Aggie have been here. It's just wonderful to have it clean, a new start.
A new start, indeed. But is there a storybook ending?
Well, now that the house is clean, Melissa's letting the kids come over. The grandkids, I have them over. Anthony comes in and, whoa, Nana, this is cool.
And that's the tale of the gloriously gleaming grandma. Now Kim and Aggie play Mother Goose, or Mother's Geese, to a gaggle of girls and boys.
Do you like story time?
Yeah.
Good. Once upon a time, there were two fairy godmothers who came all the way to America in search of filthy homes to clean.
They clean dirty floors and filthy carpets.
They clean stinky toilets with poo-poos and pee-pees.
And they found lots of scary things along the way. Bugs and mice and dangerous life-threatening bacteria and loads. Yes, little one?
Can I get a bathroom?
Make sure you wash your hands, thank you. Yes?
I'm four. I don't like your English stories.
I think our work here is done.
I think you're right there, Kim.
Woo! 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 Woo!
My God, Kim, there's loads more to do. I certainly hope Charlotte appreciates all this work. Aggie's lost her wand.
Oh, gosh. Hold on. Yeah. A little bit more in the middle. Yep.
We got to go a little bit further, Kim.
All right, hold on. Mm. Kim, we can still see you there, my dear.
Well, I can't tuck it up. Right, how many takes is this?